Yeah. Well, let me tell you about the Freemasons here. We're a traditional country British pub. We try to appeal to everyone. Our food is not pretentious, or we try not to be. We try to cook, you know, a broad spectrum of food for a lot of people. Welcome to the Freemasons. My name is H, which is short for Howell Griffith. Welcome to the Freemasons. I'm just going to show you what we're about today. The Gooseneck duck, roasted with honey and lavender, with fennel, pickled peach, yakitori livers on toast. So the duck is water bathed at 58 degrees for an hour, and then the skin is rendered down to give it that nice golden crisp you see. On the top, we've got some nice local honey, some lavender, all nicely toasted under the grill. You've got some duck livers, which are glazed in yakitori sauce, which is a Japanese apple soy glaze. What do I think our customers are looking for? I think, you know, people go out, they dine all over the place. But I think what it really boils down to is value for money, and making sure that customer is happy to pay for the product that they're getting. So it doesn't matter whether it's a burger from wherever, or it's the best tasting menu you've ever had anywhere. At the end of the day, the customer has to be happy to pay the price for that meal. So here we've got foie gras, which is poached and roasted. Gotta get strawberry, smoked eel and beer vinegar. So the beer vinegar cuts through the richness of the foie gras, which has been poached at 58 degrees for 8 minutes. And then we chill it on ice and we sear it. And give it a quick flash into the grill before it's away. And you can see all that lovely smoked eel, which has been grated on top of the gotta get strawberry. That gives it just a really nice smoky background flavour to the dish. How do I want our customers to feel when they dine here? You know, the most important thing for me, for when a guest comes again, is that they're happy. You know, there's nothing better than finishing a service on a Saturday night and coming out, you know, it's buzzing here, and there's just large groups of people, they're talking and laughing and everybody's happy, and somebody just walks up and says, "Oh, brilliant meal, chef," you know, it just adds to the adrenaline rush, you know. So it's very important that the, you know, from a customer point of view, that, you know, everybody's happy and it kind of adds to the evening for them. So just have a good evening. We have Jersey Royal potatoes, which are cooked in bacon dashi, which is simply a normal dashi infused with ham hock stock, Giro mushrooms, crispy hen egg, and Iberico ham. On the bottom there you see mushroom ketchup, and the sauce is a dashi and ham stock emulsion that you see over the egg in the middle there. How would I describe our cooking style here? Well, I'd say first and foremost is flavour is our, you know, the flavour of each individual ingredient has to stand for itself. It has to, you know, a piece of turbot has to taste of turbot, a piece of beef has to be a beautifully aged, stunning, you know, real depth of flavour to it. I think we're very clean, very precise flavours here. And more than anything is that the flavour of the dishes and, you know, the cleanliness of them has to meet the customer's expectation. So here we have extra large diver scallop. They're barely touched. They go on the plate nice and raw. Right at the end they get sprayed with yuzu juice and season just before they go in the restaurant, just to keep that fresh, you know, the essence, the freshness of the scallop. On top, you have some beautiful summer greens, a bit of chervil on there, soup of Manx and Queenies, and roast shellfish oil.
One.
Let me tell you how we balance quality and value. When the customer's expectations are met, it almost doesn't matter to them whether they've paid £20 for their three courses or they've paid £30 for their main course. We do our seasonal menu and it is more basic, but that's granted. The only difference is that they might have less elements on a dish. You know, we source the best ingredients for all the menus here at Freemasons, so you know, there's no real cheaping, you know, making a cheap menu, if you like. We just kind of rein back on the ingredients that we serve on a dish. Here we have roast Herdwick lamb from Cumbria. Roast, you've got a nice roast rack there, nice braised breast of lamb as well, you can see it rolled up. Roast red pepper puree, poached Cevennes onions, and we've got some beautiful ewe's curd, which adds a nice creamy freshness to the dish. And that's just topped with dried Kalamata olives. How important is it to have a good front of house team? You know, it's just as important to having a good front of house team as it is a kitchen team. Because the food might be great, but if the service is not that good, then, you know, it doesn't matter. You know, we're all one big team here. We don't really look at ourselves as front of house and back of house. We're all just one big team. So here we have a classic British vanilla slice with a slight twist on it that we do here. So you can see them beautiful layers of puff pastry. The top one is glazed with a beautiful caramel topping. In the middle you have some vanilla cream. Gotta get strawberries, gotta get semi-gel, beautiful salted caramel ice cream, and some nice honeycomb there as well. Is it difficult and challenging to run a restaurant? Well, with catering, I truly believe you're either born to do it or you're not. You know, it's not something you do half-heartedly. I think it's very rewarding. You know, all that work and everything that goes into it. And yeah, there's good days, there's bad days, but at the end of the day, you must enjoy it, and that's the key thing. So here we have Amalfi lemon. Obviously, Amalfi is where the lemons are from, down in Italy there. So, lemon meringue pie. On the plate there, you see some beautiful toasted meringue. Some Alfonso mango, bit of dried meringue. Fresh passion fruit, freshly zested lemon, zest all over the top, and passion fruit ice cream on the side there. So, nice citrusy dish. Chef, what would I be? What other job would I do? Sitting here right now, I can't really answer. There's loads of things I like doing, but you know, being a chef is who I am, and it doesn't matter what you do, as long as you do it to the best of your ability. And I truly believe that. Whether you're a chef, you're a bin man, whether you work in a garage, whether you work, it doesn't matter where you work. But as long as you do something to the best of your ability, and you go home at the end of the day, and you think, do you know what, I couldn't have done any better today. And, you know, I know that doesn't really answer the question, but I just thought it was important to get that across. We have the Michel Clouzel dark chocolate. It's a single estate, vanilla, and Pedro Ximenez poached pineapple with brown butter ice cream. So we have some passion fruit semi-gel, fresh passion fruit, and some rum poached raisins on the plate there as well.